Let me introduce myself. I am a credit controller at Best Run, and my job is to improve our processes. And this is why I'm in SAP Signavio right now, because I need the insights. And I already see credit risk analysis is taking too long. Let's drill into this. And there it is. Seems like credit holds are slowing down our order to cash process significantly. But most of these are customers that already have sales contracts. Let's fix this. So I'm going to open up a conversation with Joule, asking that we need to speed up the time. And Joule comes back to me saying, sure, we can create an S4HANA extension with the agent we just built to perform automatic credit analysis. Sounds perfect to me. So I say we follow this recommendation and generate it in SAP Build. And this takes us directly to the SAP Build lobby. And today we are previewing a future new capability in SAP Build's tool for developer. We are using the vibe coding concept to build intelligent applications through what we call intent-based development. So I'm just going to speak my intent to Joule. So Joule, I do need to find a simple way for managing these value contracts. And go. Perfect. And just look at this. Joule is creating a detailed end-to-end specification based on SAP Build's CAP, Fiori, Automation, and HANA, all in the context of our business. And it's all defined and aligned to our best practices and clean core principles. What more could I wish for? So let's create this application. On the left, you can see Joule now reasoning step by step, planning, building, even fixing its own mistakes on the way. And it's using the SAP Build MCP agent to now generate a full stack application. And it is doing extensive reasoning and content generation here, as you see. And technically, after a few minutes on the right, you'll see the completed solution with the summary of everything Joule has created. And that's exactly what we mean by intent-based development. Joule turned this idea, this insight, and turned it into a complete architected solution. And without leaving SAP Build, right here we're going to preview the app. Perfect. We see that it has been generated using SAP Build's UI5 framework, which is great because one of the many great capabilities is that it has strict accessibility guidelines. Because yes, we're wipe coding, but we're wipe coding enterprise applications here. But looking at this, I have an idea. I want high value contracts to send out. So let's take this intent to Joule, asking to add an indicator, and perfect. Joule is now updating the UI, describing the changes, and we can even refresh the app live. Looks good. Love the icons, Joule. Let's look at the code view for this one. I do want to see behind the scenes. And perfect. We see the UI5 annotation perfectly added. If I had to write this by hand, I'd be looking up the syntax just as it is here and hoping that it works. So SAP Build is redefining developer productivity. It's creating intelligent applications, and not just faster, but smarter. Let's take a look at the process and how this was been created. So we're going to take a look back and see how it is. And wonderful. All the time when a contract is created or the value is increased, it's running perfect, and it's using the agent that Karishma built earlier. And actually, Joule can even explain to me the entire process in step-by-step detail. Wonderful. But let's switch gears a bit and see how we would edit it in an agentic tool. And we're now in VS Code. I have my app there, CAP service, UI5, all at the right point. And I also have our new SAP Build MCP agents for CAP CDS development right here, also for our UI5 MCP agent, and of course our Fiori agent. And today we will be using Cline, which is one of the possible setup that Michael mentioned earlier. So let's vibe code, shall we? I'm going to take my intent to Cline, asking that we need to create an extension to include the report from Karishma's agent. And Cline gets to work, collaborating with our MCP agent, and it modifies the CAP service, adjusts the Fiori annotations, verifies the syntax, it checks for best practices, and even tests it all autonomously. And in real time, you can see the edits, the difference, and the updates. So this is real true developer AI partnership in action. And we're done already. implemented and verified. Perfect. So every extension that we wanted to have is now implemented already. So good job. And with a few clicks, I'm now deploying the app to BTP, and these are all of the recently processed contracts. To see a solution in action, I'm just going to change up this value to 500,000. Perfect. Hit save. Now, behind the scenes, our agent is triggered, and it's performing the new creditworthiness analysis. And we see that the check completed, and we now see that the status is updated, and the new research report from the agent has been stored for our review. And this means that now every sales order against this contract can be processed efficiently without any of the delays from the credit holds we saw earlier. And the best part, all of this happened naturally through conversation. Because with intent-based development, you will take your developer productivity to new levels. So now let's let some time pass and see the impact of the extension we just built. So a few months later, we are in Signavio Process Intelligence to finally see the outcome. And every node in the process is green, and the numbers really do speak for themselves. And this is the power of intelligent applications. From this insight, through its intent, to action, from Signavio to Joule to Build, all in one flow. And that's how I, a credit controller at Best Run, turned this process bottleneck into a competitive advantage using generative AI and intent-based development.